It looks like Intel is actually getting really serious about entering the discrete graphics market. And what used to be known as DG2 is now known as Arc. Now, before I jump into today's video, I just want to say that this video was inspired by an article over on The Verge. And with that said though, let's talk tech Intel style. Intel is branding its upcoming consumer GPUs as Intel Arc. Now, this new Arc brand will cover both the hardware and software powering Intel's high-end discrete GPUs, as well as multiple hardware generations. The first of those, known previously as DG2, is expected to arrive in the form of codename Alchemist in Q1 of 2022. A little bit off, but at least it's right around the corner. Intel's Arc-based Alchemist GPUs will be available in both desktops and notebooks in early 2022, with Intel seemingly aiming to compete against both AMD and NVIDIA, which is quite a challenge. While we still don't know much about the performance of the first Alchemist GPUs, Intel today released a video that showed the prototype silicon powering PUBG, Psychonauts 2, Metro Exodus, and more. So let's check out that clip right now. Intel's Arc GPUs will be capable of mesh shading, variable rate shading, video upscaling, and real-time ray tracing. Sounds good so far, right? Most importantly, Intel is also promising AI-accelerated supersampling, which sounds like Intel has its own competitor to NVIDIA's Deep Learning Supersampling, DLSS for you people who don't know what that is. AMD launched its own FidelityFX Super Resolution FSR answer to DLSS in June, but it's only using a spatial upscaling technique, rather than an AI-based temporal upscaling. The aim of all these technologies is to upscale games from the lower resolution to provide smoother frame rates without a noticeable compromise in image quality. The launch of the Intel Arc brand and the reveal of future hardware generations signifies Intel's deep and continued commitment to gamers and creators everywhere, says Roger Chandler, head of Intel's client GPU business. He says, "We have teams doing incredible work to ensure we deliver first-class and frictionless experiences when these products are available early next year." Intel is only teasing right now its new brand of GPUs and revealing that Celestial, Battle Mage, and Druid will all be upcoming code names for their future discrete graphics cards. There'll be more information about this later on in 2021. So far, Intel has launched its first Iris Xe graphics cards, codenamed DG1, that use the company's Xe LP architecture. These lower power cards were mainly designed for pre-built workstations instead of dedicated gaming rigs. Intel's upcoming Arc GPUs, however, will be based on the company's Xe HPG microarchitecture, which is a combination of the work Intel has been putting into its Xe LP, HP, and HPC microarchitectures. So at the end of the day, you guys have to admit, this sounds like pretty good news. Intel finally entering the graphics market. Now, whether these cards will actually be available, that will be yet to be seen. How great the performance actually will also have to be yet to be seen. But I think overall, it's a really cool thing that Intel's actually going to be entering this market and competing. And since we see there are going to be different generations of these cards, hopefully they'll start out in the mid-level and then work their way all the way up to being really competitive with AMD and NVIDIA. That's what we're all looking for. We're looking for cards that are competitive, that are well-priced, and that will be available on the market to gamers everywhere. Another thing is hopefully Intel will do something about mining and put a block inside there so people cannot use these cards for mining whatsoever. That way they can come directly out to you folks, the gamers, who actually care about graphics cards and the industry and aren't just out to make a quick buck. With that said, I'm Elric. You guys have been watching Tech of Tomorrow. I really appreciate your viewership. If you'd like to keep my channel around for a single single dollar you can support me on Patreon. That's right, a single dollar bill per month to keep me around. Or you can try Amazon Prime for free down below. I have a link there where you can try it for 30 days. They give me a little bit of cash. It just keeps things rolling along. So peace out. We'll see you guys back here for more tech here on Tech of Tomorrow.